Let me introduce the Agile planning routine and show very shortly how it's working in Business Central, and then in other videos I will go into details for each of the steps. Let's see how it works. First of all, step number one, create planned supplies for all existing not covered demands while ignoring the due date perspective. This means from the reverse planning, I will need to break down everything that has no supply, and therefore I will calculate critical items, and depending on the iteration I am in, I will do this on serial level or safety stock level and including forecast or not. So in this scenario, which is most critical, I will not include forecast and calculate according to serial on one location. And since it doesn't break down the hierarchy structure, I need to do this as many times as I have level in my hierarchy. I suggest quantity to order, maybe using order multipliers, and change the action message and carry out the orders. And this will create lines in my quick journal in here. And now, due to those items that has components on those lines, it will create new lines when I run it again. So I will do the same step. And again, suggest quantity to order, and I'm suggesting up to zero because this is the most critical iteration I'm running. And I'm changing action messages and carry out orders. I have to do this until there's no more lines, and instead of doing like I'm doing here, I could just check mark the two auto run suggest quantity and auto run create orders, meaning it will calculate, enter the line, suggest quantities, and move the lines into the journal. So I'll just run this a few times. And I think I'm done now. And to test it, we can just remove the two check marks to see if we have more lines in here. And we're done. So now everything is into the quick journal, everything that we need to do, all the items we need to handle, but the dates are, of course, a mess. Let's look at point two. Second, we would add the most realistic immediate receipt dates on the new purchase supplies. Let's do that in Business Central. So for instance, on some of my items, I will look at the purchase items in here and look at the dates, and maybe this one is not possible to get before 12th of April like this, and maybe another line up here instead of in March. And I'll have to contact the vendors or just to add the immediate dates that I think could be possible for those items if I know my vendors. And this way I'm entering whatever changes I believe will be on the dates. Just write immediate. Let's look at step three. So now I can calculate moving demand dates while including the planning lines to see the impact on the sales orders. So back in the reverse planning journal, I could now suggest moving demand dates in here. And I need to deselect the trigger on the inventory. And this will, if I'm including planning lines, that I am, I've checkmarked the include planning lines functionality, it will run through all the items, calculate how to move the sales orders to get a view on everything that I need to move to make it possible. And if I scroll down, I can see my sales orders in the end, my top level orders down here, meaning all those sales orders probably need to be moved from whatever due date here to new due dates. Looking at the sales line that it wants to move, I can see, for instance, it wants to move a sales order from 10th of April till 8th of June. And I need now to discuss with my salespeople if this is okay or this is a big issue. And maybe they say, this is too much, we need to do something. And this brings us to next step. So the next step will be to find the most critical purchase supply based on the delayed sales orders and then to get the best out of our vendors. Let's go back in Business Central. So from the sales order that is delayed, we could navigate into the hierarchy of items that are delayed, all the delays in here. And in this hierarchy, I could filter on purchase items, trying to find the purchase items that are most critical with delayed dates. For instance, this one is delayed 61 days. And I do have other purchase items that are delayed quite as long. Let's try to look. So I'm filtering on my, it's still production components that I want to move, but it's purchased items used for production company. And if I'm looking at the three ones with the most delay and I scroll left, I can see it's actually the same item. So thereby it's possible for me to find the purchase items that are due or causing the biggest delay on the sales orders. So now I need to do at least something about those items. So if I enter my quick journal and I can find the item, if it's in here, I need to do something about it, if possible. Or if it's not in the quick journal, there's already orders, existing orders on this item, and I need to handle that because that's the most urgent item. So I'll need to talk to my vendors and see what we can do to make this better. Maybe we could fly it in, and then if we're flying in it, let's say we can get it on another date here. So we will optimize the delivery date on the purchase sites. Let's take the next step. So next, when I'm done with all the critical purchase items, I will bundle the rest of the purchase items per vendor per due date to create realistic purchase orders. This means when I'm looking here in my planning worksheet, maybe all the lines for the same vendor here has the same date. That would be very nice, of course, but if they don't have the same date like this on vendor number 30,000, I might want to bundle those two because it's not realistic that I'm getting two items from the same vendor within a 6-date interval, and therefore I will change the date to be more realistic per vendor. I'm doing this in the quick journal. Let's look at the next step. Step number 6, now I can calculate moving demand dates with the new expected purchase supplies that doesn't get better and that I have bundled to see how it looks on the sales orders. So I would now delete all my suggested demand move because now I need to calculate it again. Or it will be deleted when I calculate it actually. So I'll calculate suggest moving demands again and still include all planning lines. So I've checkmarked the include planning lines, and therefore it takes into account the new changes I made on the purchase orders, and therefore I hope my sales orders are getting better than June 8 that it did just before. So if we are scrolling down to my sales items again down here, and we're looking at the new due date, now we are back on May 17, which is the best we can do. So this is what we need to suggest our customers. Let's look at the next step. Next, we will carry out action messages to vendors and confirm with production. And if we're doing master capacity planning, this is where we need to do it as well. This means, first of all, we would like to actually suggest everything that the movement did in here. So all the suggested movement will be carried out, meaning we are creating sales order handlings and we are modifying the existing quick journal, So this is the sales orders to move. And here we have the quick journal now with all the reschedules that we need to do on existing orders and all the change date on the purchase orders. So this is our action that we need to carry out now. So we need to order the new purchase items and we need to move all those production orders in here. And if we're doing master capacity planning, this is the time to figure out if the production can actually do this on the date. And of course, if the production can't do that, we need to change the date on the production orders as well to make sure the capacity planning is okay, and then recalculate the movement of sales orders once again. So from in here, when we're all ready, we will proceed and carry out action messages to firm planned orders, assembly orders, etc., and create all these orders in here, meaning that we are sending the mails to vendors, updating the production orders or assembly orders if we had those, and transfer orders, etc. So this is now the plan being carried out from the quick journal. Let's look at the next step. So the last thing would be to inform our salespeople about the sales orders to move and the lines in the sales journal, which means that my quick journal is empty in here, but my sales order handling contains all these lines, and I need to hand those over to the salespeople, asking them to move this date for the customers, because this is the realistic date that we can actually do. And if I want to control that everything is correct, I could calculate again for critical item, and hopefully nothing should pop up looking for critical items. It should be empty, and when I move demand dates in here, suggest moving demand dates, and I include sales order handling, and I need to do this without the end check mark, it should also be empty because I included the sales order handling lines. So now I'm all done. My planning, both critical and move, is empty, and I can go to lunch.